It's showtime. Thank you. Stand up.
Oh, God. Oh, no. Oh, God. No, no, no.
keep doing it. Get out of there, Flair. Get out of there.
You are not wrong! this to be a night that wrestling fans will not forget. guys gave it to him. And he performed. He said he's gonna leave absolutely nothing left in this ring by the end of the night, and I hope that you thought you got your money's worth.
Are all over the place. We'll talk a little bit more about it when we get in the car. As you see, there is a crap load of people. All right, so, well, that was an emotional roller coaster if I ever saw one. Oh my God. Yeah, I cried during that like intro with the theater, and like, yeah, as I was saying, I basically cried the entire time. During that match, anyway. Not so much during the others. I'm going to be honest with you. I thought the pay-per-view as a whole was pretty lackluster, other than the Ospreay match and the final match with Sting.
Match was okay.
It was okay, but...
But I think I was so tired by that point in time, yeah, I didn't care. I just wanted it to be over.
Yeah, we were exhausted. Yeah.
I was getting into it with the Young Bucks.
She let the Young Bucks have it.
They put Darby through glass. They were
technically. I think Darby put himself through glass, but
no, he did other things. Want to know what I said to them?
He got cut all to pieces. Jesus.
Want to know what I said to them, guys? I said, Matt and Nick Jackson, y'all are gone for life, and I'm gonna whoop your butts when I get over there. And I will, and you will never hide from me.
She did say that.
Everywhere you go, it's me.
I mean, you know, Solo doesn't want none from her. I'm just saying. I don't think they do either. But anyway, I was not, you know, the matches themselves were just okay. The Ospreay Takesha match was, oh my god.
The 8-man scramble was somewhat disappointing.
It was very disappointing. It was
kind of
with all the talent they had in that ring, they could have done. I felt like it was kind of.
It was a little predictive too.
I think pretty much everyone knew Wardlow was winning that. But
well, I mean, I felt like the Toni Storm Deonna Purrazzo match was pretty good.
Yeah. It was pretty good. It ended very, very
weird.
Weird, but.
I think the women's match on Zero, like the pre-show, was actually better.
Oh, Julia and Sky with Willow and Stack.
That should have been on the main card.
Honestly, I agree with that, actually.
I would take that instead of the 8-man
show. But Sting, just he's the man. He will always, you can say Ric Flair all you want, but. Sting is the man. He's the goat. He's the greatest of all
and
time.
Ricky Steamboat.
Ricky Steamboat. That was a kind of a surprise.
Yeah.
So, I knew Rick was going to be there.
And his sons. Oh my. Literally had to do a double take. Especially
when he came out, I thought it was actually him. I thought it was
Sting. Like, yeah. Cut his hair again and had the bubble butt and everything.
And bleached his hair. I thought it was him too.
I was like, oh my, I was literally screaming like, oh my god.
And then Wolfpack Sting came out and I was like, oh, okay, that's not Sting.
But I was like, who is that? And someone had to tell me that's his son. And I was like, well, I probably should have figured because literally, especially Steven as Surfer Sting literally is just like.
He looks perfect.
Just like him, like down to the bubble booty in those pants and everything.
I'm not eating M&M's right now.
I don't blame you if you are. I'm glad you share some with me. But anyway, that was a very emotional night. Now we're exhausted and we're waiting to get out of traffic. So
yeah,
it's probably gonna be 2:00 before we get home, and she's got school and we both have work. So this should be very interesting. But anyway, we will go ahead and sign off.
Have an M&M, guys.
Have an M&M.
Yum.
Bye.